Okay, now we are entering into the another important topic, that is on AIX, so which is an a very advanced topic. So we olden, I can say, like, it's for the old projects we were using some AIX, but most of the projects where I work, I think I have came across this AIX only once in my work life. So apart from that, I didn't come across this. So once the DB2 came, right, so after most of the projects we started using DB2, so then we have been not using this AIX. So what is AIX? AIX is nothing but it's called as an alternate index. If we need other than primary key, then we define an alternate index. To define the AIX, below are the steps we need to do. So define AIX with ID cams, then we need to build a path, and then we have to build that. Why we have to go? So when multiple, for example, let's take a real-time example. So let's say, like, you're working on an insurance project. Okay, within an insurance project, you will be, if a X person with an SSN number has taken multiple policies, and I wanted to look at how many policies being taken by this particular SSN number, right? So if you look into the policy table, so the policy ID will be the primary key, and it followed by the SSN number, right? Policy number, SSN number, policy number, and SSN number. How do I track of it each? So in that case, what we can do is we can combine SSN number and the policy number combined together. So that together combination will form an AIX. Or let's take if a person is having multiple bank accounts. He's having multiple bank accounts, and in each bank he will provide his SSN number, right? So based on SSN number only, his bank account is created, right? So if I want to look at the balance, what is the balance available, total balance available for that particular customer within all the banks, let's say, like, we can take a big billionaires where they may be having multiple accounts in different banks. I wanted to see what is the total balance they have. So I mean, it's like if a government is wanted to check who all have a huge money, so they will keep an eye on those accounts and they will monitor it. So in that case, so we can have an alternate index created with the tax number or SSN number and account number combination, right? Let's say, so this is the policy data that you have. So here you have a policy number and so on, name, area, state, district, and you have the policy number added here, right? So then how the code looks, AI index, first what we need to do is we need to create an AIX. So how do we create? Using an ID cams utility, and you need to specify the record size and the keys. And the key that you are mentioning, so it will also have the index and the data. So specifying that key is equal to 4, 0, since it is a policies of 4 bytes. So that we have created the KSDS policy here, and then you are trying to load the data into the KSDS file. So before that, what we are trying to do is we are trying to create a KSDS file initially before creating I'm trying to create a KSDS file, so with all this information copied, right? So first step, we need to create a KSDS file. So where I'm just forget about this part. So first I'm trying to create a KSDS file which holds the policy information, right? So step 2 is to copy the data to an KSDS file. Then after that, what we are doing, so we are trying to create an AIX. So AIX is again created using ID cams with name as AIX, and you have to give your AIX file name, right? Once this is done, so you need to create a path. So how do you create the path? You need to create a path by name, giving it as AIX path, and you have to map the AIX that you have given there. And then we need to copy the data that is from KSDS file to AIX. So that means we are trying to build the index file now. So how the index file, in the sense, so we had that policy number and SSN number, right? So now in the combination of those two, the files gets created. So now since build has done, so first we have created an AIX, then we have defined a path, then we have tried to build it. Then after that we need to print the data. What do we have? So printing the data means, so whatever the policy information that was there, so that it will be printed in the AIX file. So let me connect to the mainframe and show you so how the data looks. So what we had here, MADF policy.info.k, let's take that AIX. So this is the steps I have followed there. So let me see. So while building an AIX, just I want to show you here. So what are the two key factors? One is the name of the AIX and to which you are relating. You are relating to policy and you are giving all the rest of the properties in the AIX, and then you have build a path to that. You have build a path like this, and then you have finally build the index so that this particular data is being copied from this. And now I'm trying to take this and try to print this and see what the information that it has. Not sure if it is holding any data or not, but ideally we'll see. Oh good, so it has some data there. So now it should have some policy number along with the SSN number. Now you can see the policy number and SSN number, policy number and SSN number, that's been added, right? So this is how we build an AIX index. The AIX is nothing but it's a combination of two different primary keys. So in that case only we create an alternate index.